else wants another workout?
How long
does
it take to drink an
hour?
I have about two weeks ago.
Obviously, you didn't do anything on the field in Indianapolis, but walk us through that process and what that was like.
Yeah, Indy was cool. I mean, it's long days, but it was good. Just certain days we had like media and medical stuff, and then a bunch of interviews and meetings at night. So yeah, it was good. It was a long day. It was good.
The conversations that you've had with the team so far, GMs, head coaches, scouts, whatever, what do they want to know the most from you?
I think a lot of it just is one question is about medical stuff. Like, I mean, that's kind of the main thing they dig into. Like ankle, what just happened, and then also just what kind of person I am. And, yeah.
How difficult is this to get your teammates
to
the
place
where
you're
not
being able to? Yeah, it's tough to stand out here watching because I want to be out there and doing stuff.
Brock, how is the ankle? Are you fully clear? How is that feeling?
Yeah, no, it's fully 100%. I mean, I've been pretty good, but yeah, it's been good.
From the combine to here, have there been any results from your former teammates that you're like, I can't believe you ran that fast, or you guys had the conversation or Aaron impressed you?
Yeah, I mean, we're all poke fun. So I was happy for Tyke and like Bull and all them. I heard Kamari ran good today too. The lad obviously ran fast. I always tell Lad we can race. I'll be. I don't know about that. We'll see.
What is it about Georgia that prepares you guys as a team and has prepared you specifically for the league?
Yeah, I think it's all about the mindset stuff coming here. I mean, we work so hard every single day, and I feel like that, like the coaching and the people who are around, especially like practicing against, and we're practicing against so many talented guys and gifted guys. So I think that helps a lot in the development process.
What are you gonna miss about playing here, practicing here?
I think I'm just gonna miss all the dudes. I mean, it's tough to go our separate ways, but it was awesome to see everyone again today. And yeah, I guess I'm gonna miss most.
And what was your reaction to Pierce Sperling and the unfortunate medical retirement? And just reach out to him, say anything to him after it?
Yeah, I reached out to him and see how he's doing. I mean, that's tough. I mean, just want to play. I mean, you always want to play football at the highest level, and he made it. He was able to play one season, so it's good for him. But I feel bad for him.
How many teams and who are you talking to today? Since you weren't able to take, were you able to talk to more teams today?
I was walking around, just hanging out, I guess, and talking to some people.
Brock, they say it's all on tape with you. Clearly, you did miraculous things at Georgia, but is there a competitive urge for you to compete in some of these field events, like you said, or is it just part of the duties of preparing for the NFL?
Yeah, definitely. I want to be out there competing against dudes, and I want to try to, beat everyone's time.
You mentioned that a second ago. You kind of set the bar for yourself with a 4-3 now.
No. Yeah, dude. It sucks. Man. It's not that much.
How many team visits do you have scheduled?
I mean, I'm still working on scheduling all
that. Brock got on Oscar. You know, obviously, he had an opportunity to kind of replace you down the stretch, but now he's the old guy in the room. What advice have you kind of given him as stepping up as that next leader and as the next go-to guy at tight end?
Yeah, I think a lot of what he's learned through the last 2 years, I mean, just kind of instilled in him. I hope he can translate all the next guys and just keep the tradition going tight end.
And then with a guy like Jane Riddell, you know, what have you gotten to see from him, especially coming in as a young freshman? What have you gotten to see from him as just a pure ability standpoint? And what do you think of his player so far?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't been able to watch much. I've only been back a week, but I mean, I heard he's been working hard and running fast and all the workouts. I mean, I'll have heard a few things.
Have you researched the top 10 or 12 teams in the draft and done a little homework at who might be interested in maybe some of the quirks or differences between the teams?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I don't have much. I just have control of what I'm doing right now, so I mean, it's kind of hard to pay attention to all that. But I'm sure I'll figure it out closer to the draft.
Is there a pretty good variety, though, in terms of when you look at how NFL teams use tight ends when you break it down? How different it can be from one franchise to the next?
Yeah. I mean, I feel like wherever I go, I feel like I can be used in a bunch of ways, and I feel like that would be how I'd be used best, and everything like that. So I would like go to a place that everyone needs.
Brock, this whole process only comes around once for you guys. How long has this been a dream for you, and how do you just remember that this is all happening in real time?
Yeah, I mean, I guess. The time I really wanted to play, I remember sitting in my living room, like watching Monday Night Football and just looking at the TV and be like, I want to play there one day. Just be able to live that dream and hopefully be able to do that at the next level.
Rock, what are some of the things when you sit down with teams and they tell them to take some of the things they ask you that they want to know about end game?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of it is asking what I could have done better on certain plays, and I mean, a lot of it's about football knowledge too, like what the defense is doing, what they're rolling to, and it's kind of all like the little things, I guess.
You plan to be in Napa on draft night?
I think that's the plan.
Do you know, for that early April workout, what you're going to participate in and do?
I'm not sure yet. I'm just going to see.
Is there a team that your girlfriend or your parents that you've spoken to that you're excited about?
I mean, I don't know. Obviously, my parents are both, my mom's a big Niner fan, so right around there, so that'd be cool.
Cameron?
Yeah, I mean, she doesn't watch the Blackhawks. She's fine for them.
Who's given you just the best piece of advice during this process and has really kind of helped you during all this?
Man, I mean, it's hard to say just one person. I mean, Coach Harley has helped me a ton along the way. I mean, he was there for me every single day here. Then just obviously pushed me super hard every single day at practice, workouts, every single time. So, I mean, just everyone here, I feel like.
You spoke so highly of Latt. So what is an NFL team going to get if they get Latt and you see them rise over the years?
Yeah, I mean, I think he's just a hard-working dude, just a grinder, and I mean, he's obviously fast and gifted on the field, so I think they're just going to get a great dude, just a football player.
What's an NFL team
going to
get with you?
I think I'm pretty versatile, and I mean, as long as I feel like I'm going to be used a lot of different ways, and I hope to be just used a lot of different ways. I feel like that's what I'm best.
Thanks, Brian.